probably like looking forward for me to be like, you know, the best. I couldn't let y'all down. Like, the ring rust came from just like the nonstop training. Shout out my brother right here, KP. He came in camp and straightened out the kinks, and Steve Dollars and Michael Bishop, they stayed on me, you know, every day of the way. And Wesley, my brother, we all, you know, we just stayed locked in, and it was just like a matter of time, you know. I feel good coming back. No excuses about like not stopping them, you know. We went 10 rounds. I was ready for 10. I could have went 5-1 rounds. I felt good in it. I had fun coming back. It was a fun fight for me. But I got to tip my hat off to Jose Benavidez Jr. He did awesome. He put up a fight. I couldn't tell that he didn't, he wasn't shooken up by me at all, but I heard him a couple times and I just looked at him like, I'd rather tonight get the 10 rounds than go ahead and knock him out. So y'all haven't seen me in a while anyways. I get some, you know, some rounds in. That's what Ike was telling me the whole time. Ike kept telling me, it's cool, you know, knock him out, get the rounds in, right? So, got it done.
Jermall, all the criticism is on the past. With this great performance of you tonight, what is the next goal for you? I mean, you got a fight in 160, you have another goal. After this great performance again, what is your next goal?
What's your name again?
Ernesto Amador, no puedes jugar a boxeo.
Ernesto, that's a great question for me, because the sky's the limit right now. I have the championship at 160, right? And it's even a vacancy inside 160, which we could attack that. I'm gonna get right back in the camp. I'm not taking no days off. I'll be training Monday. So I'm gonna get right back on it. I'm gonna give myself, you know, a little bit of time with the family. We're gonna sort it out. I'm gonna talk to Mauricio about the WBC and the things that I need to do. But I mean, I'm 68. It's hot. David Benavidez just won against Demetrius. Will be a great fight. I saw Caleb Plant in a crowd. That'll be a good fight. I know it's some competition at 168. I easily can make 168, but I mean, it's the sky's the limit right now. I'm just gonna let God do what He do, and He's gonna put me right in the right path for where I need to be, and we're gonna just keep going, man. Our legacy is our legacy.
You just mentioned that you wanted to go to 168, but at 160 you've been the belt holder. You have Carlos Adames, who's been the mandatory. You have Janabek, who's also a 160 pounder. Do any of those fights, if you can't get the 168, do those fights entice you at all? You're mandatory, maybe?
I mean, yeah, I would definitely love to step up to, you know, get right back in the banger, you know. I'll fight the Janabek, and I'll fight the mandatory, what's his name, Carlos Adams. Shout out to those guys for making it to number one. You know, they did what they had to do. I'm definitely the type of fighter to give them a chance. I've never dodged nobody, ducked nobody, just the circumstances are right. You will see me in there with them. I'm not here to like hold no bell or do nothing strange. Shout out to the WBC, you know, they understood my situation, they understood my problem. They know I'm a real champ in their division, and I love them for understanding me, and we're gonna put up, you know, the belt as soon as we fight. Like, the next fight, the belt will be on the line. If it's at 160, that's where it's going. If I gotta go to 168, I'll go to 168 and fight for this interim belt that he just won, or he just defended tonight. Like, I'm down for whatever. It's not like I'm not, you know what I'm saying, I'm not really a matchmaker. I'm not the person that's put me in these positions. I'm happy to be here, and I'll fight my way through it. But if it comes up to time and I fight Adams, and I'm pretty sure that mandatory is gonna come to the point where I have to fight Adams, and I have to fight Janabek to become undisputed, a unified division at 160. So me, KP, the team, everybody lines on. We'll get together and we'll get the best training we can, and we'll go from there.
Jermall, congrats on the win, staying undefeated, coming back to Vegas, doing your thing.
a lot was said about this whole weight thing, about your layoff. Pressure was right there, but you overcame, you delivered. And on top of that, the icing on the cake being this Showtime card, it's the last one in Las Vegas. How good did it feel to go against the challenges that you always welcome before?
It felt good. It felt good to, you know, overcome adversity. You know, at the end of the day, I faced a little bit of adversity. Don't want to keep talking about that, like, you know, we're moving forward, right? So from now on, like, when you do ask me questions about what I've been through, I'm really kind of tired of, like, lingering. It's all about, like, what I had going on. Yes, I did have some stuff going on, but, like, I'm better now. You know what I'm saying? Well, let's talk about how much better I am. Y'all just showed y'all, right? No ring rust, came in, dominated them, did what I had to do. Appreciate it, because, you know, I'm back. Like, when I said I'm back to stay. You know, it is what it is. You know, whatever happened from here on. Like, it's not just fights, it's my legacy I'm putting on the line. So I'm down for whatever.
Congratulations. Hey, what's going on, Jermall? First and foremost, congratulations and welcome back to boxing. We missed you. Just had to ask, because I know you break down boxing matchups really well. I know you were rooting for Boo to win that fight, but out of respect, I know you have respect for David. Just what was your thoughts on that fight? Just how Boo performed and how David performed, if you know what I'm asking.
I really thought Boo was gonna outbox him, but his plan was different. I can't go in there and fight for him, but he stayed on the outside too long, and he never pushed David back. To me, the feet was very sloppy on both of the fighters' standpoint. They did a lot of clashing, and I look at boxing like the dominating shots. I really didn't see, like, crazy dominating shots, but I really did see David put a lot of pressure on Boo Boo, like, not to, you know, take nothing away from David's win. He did awesome, great champ. But I didn't really see, I wasn't like crazy impressed by him. You know, I just wasn't crazy impressed by him. Like, it was a good fight though.
Thank you. Questions for Jermall Charlo. Raise your hand and we will give you the microphone.
What up, Ellie?
I'm good. So, first of all, how are you feeling right now? What's going through your mind?
Right now? Crazy. Javier, Junior, Johnson, Arias. I'm gonna go be with my family and my friends and just take some time off, chill with my Uncle Ronald, and you know, he's just like, that's a good question, though.
A lot of talk of you against Canelo, you even mentioned it in the ring afterwards. If Canelo's watching this, what do you tell him?
Pick me. Yeah, I know y'all said to fight my twin brother, but it's a whole different twin when they fight me. Like, I don't want to, you know, I'm not bashing nothing my brother did, but he dared to be great jumping up two weight classes to go fight Canelo. You know, technically that was my time to shine, but you know, I wouldn't have felt as good going into that fight like I did tonight. I mean, you know, not saying that anything about Benavidez and comparing those two, but you know, Canelo's on a way another level from Benavidez, so I think that fight would have made me get up for it. I really wasn't like motivated by this fight, but I gotta do it, you know.
That last thing, you and Jose sold this fight, the trash talk was, what do you guys tell each other after the fight?
What you mean, in the ring?
Yeah.
I just told him I beat his ass. I beat your ass. Yeah, there ain't nothing you could do. I beat your ass. Then he came back to the back of the locker room and was like, yeah, you beat my ass. I told you.
He's cool.
That's all it was. Yeah, it was cool. We finally dapped each other off. You know what I mean? It was cool. Anything else? Wow. What's up?
Hey, Jermall's got places with Mike. Go ahead.
Nah, nah.